Good afternoon, students. Today in Moral Science, Chapter 3, heading of the chapter is Be Courageous. Courage or valor is the choice and willingness to fight agony, pain, danger, etc. There are two kinds of courages: physical courage and moral courage. Okay, once again I'm repeating, two kinds of courages are there: physical courage and moral courage. Physical courage is the boldly, when the person boldly face pain, hardships, threat of death, etc. The soldiers, policemen, players, workers, these people suffer or face this kind of courage. Okay, next let us see about the moral courage. Boldly face opposition, shame, personal loss, etc. Okay, now let us see example of courage. Okay, example of courage, Subhas Chandra Bose. He was freedom fighter. Okay, he was known as Netaji. He born in January 23rd 1897 in Cuttack, Odisha state. Okay, his parents were Janakinath, father was Janakinath and mother was Prabhavati. Subhas Chandra Bose was very brilliant from the childhood. That's why he studied well and he fought for the freedom of India. Okay, now his childhood, let us see. He studied in Cuttack itself. He completed the primary, middle school, high school in 1913, and after that 1919 he completed the BA. Then he was sent to England for higher studies. Then after that, when he was studying in England, patriotism did not allow him to stay in England for long time. Then he returned and he helped Gandhiji. And after that, one more freedom fighter, Bhagat Singh. So they fought for our India. That means British people were ruling in our India, and it was very difficult for Indian people. That's why they fought against British people. In 1929, he was arrested by the British people and jailed. Okay. In 1938, after coming out from the jail, he was elected as the president of Indian National Congress. Then after that, he went to Japan, and after that he formed Azad Hind Fauj in Japan. Then once when he was going to Japan in 1945, in plane crash, he was died. That means he died. He said, Dilli Chalo. His motto was Dilli Chalo. And one more, he said, give me your blood and I will give you
freedom. So he showed the courageous, and that's why you have to also be courageous and don't be a coward person. Don't be frightened from anyone, but you have to face any kind of problems. Okay, thank you, students.